All right, it will linger on. Right now in this day 25 of the partial government shutdown, indications no relief in sight for better than 800,000 federal employees affected by all of this. Unions representing them, at least three of them, had petitioned a judge to say, give some relief here. You can't force our members to work without pay. A judge essentially shooting that down. So TSA workers who've been showing up for the job but without pay must continue to do so. Remember, they're all promised that they will be paid when the government resumes operations, but that's anyone's guess. So the fallout from this, and it's pretty distinct now, is spreading a little bit far. We've heard from Delta, which has already said the big airline. This thing is ultimately impacting the bottom line by the tune of $25 million a month. Jamie Dimon of JPMorgan Chase fame saying that this could wipe out any growth at all in the quarter we're in. The National Housing Conference CEO David Dworkin joins us right now. David, I understand, too, that anyone who has an FHA-backed loan and is looking to close on their home, they're going to have to sit and stew a while, too. That's another effect. How pervasive is this getting?
Well, it can get very pervasive, but for right now, most people are not being impacted except by fear, and we need to be careful not to scare senior citizens, for instance, into thinking that they're going to be kicked out of their homes. For people who are closing FHA mortgages, they actually can go to closing. Those contracts are being honored. And importantly, for people who are federal employees and are worried about making their February 1st mortgage payment, it's very important that they call their servicer or the company they send their payment to and tell them what's going on, remind them, because those servicers have been told to give them some grace, like as if they were in a natural disaster. Well, this is clearly not natural.
Do you get a sense that if this were to drag on as long as some fear, for example, I'm told that now, given the way things are looking on Capitol Hill, Steny Hoyer, the number two Democrat on the Hill, talking about Democrats working through, I guess, the Martin Luther King week holiday, that that won't make a difference to addressing this. At the very least, it means that any resumption of activity or even talks is delayed until late next week, if at all, that this could really just go on for quite a while.
Well, it certainly has already gone on for quite a while, and I think we're in uncharted water. I would be shocked if it went on more than another couple weeks, because every day it goes on, and I've been involved in a few of these during my career, every day it goes on, the pressure ramps up, and we're going to see more concourses close because of TSA shortages, and there are all kinds of impacts. And there's also just the general concern and disgust at what's happening in Washington. You know, we can't negotiate these things by tweet. We actually have to have people sitting in the same room. And it's just unfortunate that we have not been able to do that so far.
It is weird, too, David, and no matter what you think of the president or whatever, that Democrats invited to the White House today aren't coming. So obviously they feel we're so far apart, we're probably just wasting our time. So the president is meeting with Republicans right now. That's kind of like an echo chamber right there. So
well, I asked about
happens?
That.
What happens?
I asked about that. And in fact, Democrats who were thought to be flexible and might flip on their leadership were invited, not the leadership. And so, you know, when you have a war and you go into negotiations, you negotiate with the generals, not with the troops. So I think it would be useful to get the actual negotiators in the same room and have a negotiation rather than a photo opportunity.
Well put. Of course, even the troops, they're not coming today. So we'll see what happens. David, thank you very, very much.
Thank you.